we have all this stuff from Wacom here, and it's time to test that out. So, because on a Saturday, I'm going to teach the two masterclasses at a Camera Nu, and I have to introduce the new Wacom gear. So it's time to get it to work. Okay, I've now connected the Cintiq Pro to my MacBook Pro, because we're going to do all the tests on the MacBook Pro. Because that's the one I'm going to be using at Camera Nu. Of course, together with my Mobile Studio Pro, but for testing, etc., I'm going to use the MacBook. And this is the new Cintiq Pro. Now, you have to connect with the MacBook, the Link. And of course, here all the cables are, well, not as nice as they should be. But you have the USB, Thunderbolt, and then you have the USB-C to the Cintiq Pro. And of course, normally if you have a laptop that actually has USB-C, you can leave the Link out and just use USB-C. So that saves you a lot of junk. And this is where you actually, and this is maybe funny for some of you guys, but this is the old setup. And when you have a new laptop, you only have one cable. So in that case, no more dongle circus. And now we actually have the dongle circus. Yep. It happens. And on this side we have the power brick. It's a really small power brick, so when traveling it doesn't take up a lot of space. The Cintiq Pro is now installed, and as you can see it mirrors the screen of my laptop. You can of course also set it up as a second screen, and you can actually work in Photoshop. Of course you have touch, so you can zoom in. You can also rotate your canvas, of course. The thing that I do miss, and I have to be honest, is of course the hard keys on the side. But you can use an AK remote for this, the same thing as you have with the 27-inch Cintiq. Now, of course, this is not a proper review. I'm just testing the stuff. But I really like the design of the new Wacom tablets. They're very, very touch sensitive. They're very good with their pen. 8,000 plus pressure sensitivity points. That's insane. And they integrate very well. Now, of course, on my laptop, as you have previously seen, I use a lot of cables. But if you have a USB-C laptop, like for example the new MacBook Pros, you only need one cable and of course the power brick. So overall, the Cintiq Pro, really nice. And there's one more thing I want to show you. And it's actually on the back, because on the Cintiq Pro, you have these little stands. So you can actually put it on the table in a more upward position, which makes drawing a little bit more comfortable. And this feels a little bit better for drawing. And the other device on the agenda is actually the Intuos Pro Paper. Now the Intuos Pro we all know, of course, because those are the tablets that most of us work with, like on the desk and you look at your screen and you draw on the tablet. So those are the Intuos Pros. In the past they had a step-in model they actually called the Bamboo, but now everything is Intuos. So let's take this one out of the box and see how it performs. It's been a while since I used one of those, because I normally now use the Cintiqs. But it's gonna be fun to see what the paper edition does, because that's very special. And as soon as we connect it, we are welcomed to the Intuos Pro, and if we want to set up everything, and of course we do. And the software immediately asks me if I want to install Inkspace, and of course I say yes, because I want to use the paper version. Okay, so what is this deal about paper? Now, you know that photographers like to hold the camera, right? It has to have a certain feel, a certain grip. That's what we love. That's our camera. And with traditional artists, paper is incredibly important. It's the part of their creative process. So let's say you have a certain paper type that you really like to draw on, and then when you switch to a digital tablet or an Intuos, you just don't have that feeling. And that can actually limit you in what you can do. So of course you can draw on paper and then take a picture in portrait in Photoshop, and well, you can start inking again. In this case, what you can actually do is take your favorite piece of paper, clip it onto your Intuos, and you can just start drawing. Now, as soon as you press a button, it will actually create a new layer. The cool thing about this is that, for example, if you draw a foreground and that's sharp, you press the button and you create the background, you can later in Photoshop, because it's on a separate layer, actually blur the background. So it's a really cool feature. And think about animation. So there are many, many options that you can use these layer techniques for. And there's something else that's important. It's a vector-based graphic, though that means that you can scale it up and down as much as you like. So let's see how this Intuos Pro performs.
Okay, this is actually the large, and I have to be honest, I'm not really a fan of the large ones. I always like the medium ones because they just feel more comfortable. So, but this is the large one, and because it's a test, we'll have to do with it. And it does look great. Now the touch on the Intuos is great. I have to be honest, it's almost better than on the Cintiq Pro, but I think that's just me. It works very nice. And this was way different on the Intuos Pro that I used, and that's like two generations before. The touch just didn't work nicely, and here it's absolutely smooth. Nice. Okay, in the background it's still installing ink, so let's take a look at paper in the next scene.
Okay, when I got the explanation about the paper edition of the Intuos, I actually asked Frank from Wacom. I said, Frank, will any kind of paper work? He said, yes. What I of course meant was like the art paper or the more thicker paper. He told me that even toilet paper would work. And that's something I want to put to the test.
So, here we are. Toilet paper on an Intuos Pro. So, here we have the pen, and as soon as I hover above, it should work, so let's try. I have to be honest, this is terrible. So if you ever try to draw on toilet paper, I kid you not, and you will not like it. Okay, so I wrote my name. Let's say done. And let's see what happens.
And there we are, indeed, it works on toilet paper. Amazing. Now let's get serious.
Okay, let's try it with serious piece of paper. So you open up the clip and then you put the paper under.
Now the thing that I was afraid of is that the paper would shift during drawing, but I have to be honest, it's very, very tight, so it won't move. Don't worry.
Okay, now while drawing, you have to make sure that when you want a new layer, you have to double tap the plus, so the center part of the touch ring, and then it creates a new layer. So I'm going to try something, but do realize I'm not a professional drawer. Far from, I hardly know how to draw, but I'm still going to try something. Okay, I warned you guys, if I have to do something very quickly, it looks like this, so it absolutely is horrendous. And it already downloaded to the computer, and there we go. And now they are vector files, which I can actually open up in Photoshop. Okay, and here you can see my doodles, or weak excuse for something I tried to do on paper. So let's see how it looks. And this is the software itself from Wacom. So you can also edit in here. And here we have it. Underneath you can see all the layers. So we have layer 1, 2, 3. You can of course use your layer options like copy, delete, merge, split. So it's a pretty complete program. And of course you can also export it as a PSD, JPEG, PNG or whatever and do your work in Photoshop. So works great and the quality seems to be exactly the same as I have on paper. So really nice feature if you're into drawing and you really are picky about your paper. And as you can see here, I'm not picky about paper because, well, I can do this kind of stuff also on a Cintiq or even on toilet paper because, sorry guys, my art skills aren't up to par with these products. But still, it's very cool to test out. Hey, Anouk, what is actually the thing that you notice about the Intuos Large?
It's not that heavy.
No, it's very light, right? So when traveling, we normally take the small with us on traveling.
Yeah.
And this one is actually, I think, even lighter than the small that we have from the old series.
Could be, but it's too large for the backpack.
Yeah, it's too large for the back, but it's incredibly lightweight.
Yeah.
So if you want to do something with traveling, this is without a doubt a great upgrade from the older version because they are incredibly light.